Hey guys, I hope that you guys are doing amazing wherever you are in the world. My name is Boom Shikha and I welcome you to my channel. I welcome you to all of the different videos I've been doing on INFJ stuff and other stuff. I hope that you guys learn from them and that you guys enjoy them, and also hopefully it helps you grow a little bit as an INFJ and as an individual on this planet. In this video, I wanted to speak to you guys about how INFJs actually really feel physical and mental and spiritual pain when we're around a lot of extroverted people and there's a lot of noise around us and a lot of unnecessary conversation. All of that energy really, really hurts us. Not only hurts us because we're like, oh my God, I'm so exhausted by it, but also I feel like there's actually a physical pain involved with it, a spiritual kind of pain, a mental sort of pain that's involved with it. It's actual tangible pain that happens when you're surrounded by so much extroversion. Recently, I experienced this. I've been kind of in a cave for the last couple of weeks. As soon as I got to Chiang Mai, you know, just having my own space, I was so excited just to be on my own and to be in my apartment and to do my work without any interruptions. The only reason I would go out is to have food or to buy food and then bring it back home. And so I was spending a lot of time on my own. Of course, I have a lot of extroverted friends. I think I only have extroverted friends except for one or two introverted people. Most of my friends are ENFPs or ENTPs. It ends up that way. You know, they adopt me, they like me, and they want to hang out with me, and so they ask me to go out to all these events. Now, I can say no a couple of times, but after two or three times, I really feel terrible because they're amazing, awesome, beautiful people, and I love hanging out with them when I'm ready for it. And so I said yes to this particular event. And so I went there, and there was this person who was sitting next to me. It was an event where it was like a show, and I was sitting down on the ground. There was cushions all around. There were people all around me. And I didn't really know anyone there, so I was just sitting there chilling out, watching the crowds rumble in, you know, tumble in, just talking among themselves, just listening into some conversations, spending most of my time in my head thinking about what am I going to do when I get home? Am I hungry? Am I tired? Should I leave? And so I'm sitting there, and this individual sat down next to me. Now, as soon as she sat down, I just felt an instantaneous pain in my stomach. And all of my pain, my physical pain from all of this situation, all of this resides in my stomach. I don't feel it in my heart. I feel it in my stomach. I'll start getting digestive issues. I'd want to go to the toilet. I'd want to go pee. And I feel like an intense pain in my stomach. And so as soon as she sat down, I started feeling this random pain in my stomach. And I was thinking to myself, uh-oh. And so I'm sitting there. I'm like, wait, just be calm. Everything's fine. Nothing to worry about. You're a 35-year-old female. You can handle this stuff. You don't need to be a child about it every single time this happens. And so I was like, no, I'm not going to run away. I'm just going to sit here and let it happen. And so it did happen. She was extremely obnoxious and extremely loud. But not only that, she was the kind of person who uses the F word just because she wants to make impact or to draw attention towards herself. She was speaking really loudly for a person who is in a crowd of people who are all having conversations. She was extremely loud. And not only that, she was smoking and blowing the smoke right in my face. And I was just like, why? No, but why, people? Why can't you just have common sense? Why can't you just be good? I mean, why can't you just remember that not everyone likes cigarette smoke in their face? I was like, all right, yes, that's okay. You know, I took deep breaths and I was calm. I was calming myself down, trying to. And then she started yelling and screaming about this particular person, this Thai person who was really, really rude, and just calling her a lot of names, you know, a lot of rude names. At that point, I was like, you know what, obviously this is going to go on for the rest of the night. And I just cannot. I could not physically sit there without pain. You know, I felt sick to my stomach. I felt like if I had not left at that moment in time, I'd literally be puking my guts out, or I'd just be really, really unwell. I started getting a headache, you know, all of that stuff. And so obviously I left. I tried very hard though, and so I consoled myself with that fact. At least I tried. As soon as I left the vicinity of this human being, and I'm sure she's a really, really nice person. She obviously has friends who like her and want to talk to her. And I'm sure she's a great individual in general. Maybe she was having a bad day, right? And that's what I told myself. She's probably having a bad day. And so as soon as I left the vicinity of this individual, I instantaneously felt better. Physical pain obviously disappeared. My stomach started feeling better all of a sudden. My head started feeling better. I wasn't as tired anymore. I had been yawning a lot when I was around her because I was literally, you know, holding on to my emotions and holding on to my exhaustion. It was just too much. And as soon as I left, I started feeling a lot better. And I left and I was like, I'm sorry, I can't stay. And I walked away and I started walking towards my house. And it was such a relief. It was like night and day, basically. I felt so, so bad earlier and then so good all of a sudden. Just walking on the street by myself, I had my music on, I just walked and I chilled and I walked all the way home without any issues. It was late at night, but I was so happy to be on my own that it just gave me all this boost of energy. Now, why am I sharing this with you guys? Because I really want you guys to be aware of the fact that it's not just the fact that we don't like a lot of extroversion and a lot of noise because we can't handle it, because it's too much for us, because we get overstimulated and we get tired. It's not just physical exhaustion that actually is the case. There's actually physical pain that is involved with this. You know, this physical hurt that actually happens to our bodies and our minds and our souls when we are surrounded by so much noise and so much, just too much extroversion and too much just useless noise, like useless conversation. Why do you have to be so cruel to someone who's not even there? Why do you have to do all of these things really, really loudly? What is it all about, right? And so I want you guys to be careful, not because, you know, you might get exhausted and have to go home and sleep, but because if you keep on putting yourself in these situations, you know, these kind of extroverted situations where you're constantly pulling from yourself and you're constantly putting yourself in a situation where you get exhausted over and over and over again, it will lead to burnout. It will absolutely lead to burnout. You know, that event was a couple of days ago and I still feel exhausted by it. It took me a couple of days to actually recover from it. I slept for 12, 13 hours that night and I woke up feeling, wow, I can't believe I slept that much. It was needed. I needed it because I needed to really, really recharge myself after all of that energy had been pulled out of me. Unintentionally, I'm sure, obviously, right? Extroverts don't actually want to do these kind of things to us. They don't actually realize that it affects us so much. We have to be the ones who have to be careful. They're not doing it intentionally. They're not doing it deliberately. That's her personality. That's who she is. And people like her for it. And so it keeps on perpetuating. Probably people love the fact that she bitches around about other people and talks really loudly and uses the F word a lot. You know, that's kind of maybe a attractive thing about her to some people, right? And so, I mean, she's doing what she's doing. It's not her fault. It's not an extroverted person's fault. And it's definitely not extroverted events' fault, right? It's not their fault. It's our own priority. It's on us. The onus lies on us. You know, it's our responsibility to figure out that this situation is not conducive to my health. And I'm going to be physically exhausted if I stay here for much longer. And it's going to pull and drain all of the energy out of me. And if I don't take care of myself properly, then I'm going to be one who is exhausted. No one else is going to know. No one else is going to care. They're not going to understand this because extroverted people don't really get it. When I tell my extroverted friends I am drained and I'm exhausted and I've only been there for half an hour. I literally was only there for half an hour, I think. Yeah, I was pretty much only there for half an hour. I was already so exhausted that I couldn't handle it anymore. I mean, I was also a little bit jet lagged and I'd just been in my cave. So it was a little bit like, whoa, this is jarring all of a sudden being in such a extroverted event. So that was my fault as well. I knew going in that it would be like this, but I didn't know there was going to be an individual who was going to be so loud and obnoxious right next to me, right? The universe sending us lessons, I guess, right? And so we really have to be careful for ourselves. We have to take the responsibility back upon ourselves. No one else is going to care that you get exhausted by the fact that there are extroverted people around. And if you're an INFJ or an introverted person in general, there's probably a lot of extroverted people around you. I think I mentioned this earlier that both of my parents are extroverted people. And I mean, my siblings are introverted. So we all, you know, we did get along really well, my siblings and I. But our parents would always look at us, you know, doing our own thing, reading our book and not going out or not socializing that much. And they'd always wonder if there was something wrong with us. They'd always be asking us, are you all right? Are you feeling all right? Are you depressed? Are you sad? My mom still asks me that. And I'm 35. I mean, I'm sitting at home and I'm chilling out and I'm happy. And she'll be like, are you all right? You haven't gone out in days and you haven't seen any of your friends. And is everything all right? Are you feeling okay? And I think to myself, I couldn't be better. But this is something that you have to explain, obviously, to your extroverted people around you. Maybe they might understand. But mostly it's for yourself, to understand yourself better so you can live in this world a little bit better. Because unfortunately, or fortunately, it is an extroverted person's world. there are more extroverted people in the world than introverts. I think it's 25% to 75%. So 75% of the world is extroverted, which is a really big ratio difference, right? And also sensing versus intuitive, I think it's pretty much the same as well, 25% versus 75%. So there's a lot of extroverted sensors out there, which those are the kind of people who love to do this kind of stuff. They like to go to baseball games. They like to go to really, really loud basketball games where there's a lot of cheerleading and there's a lot of noise and there's a lot of those blowing horn things that I'm just like, wow, why? And so this is the world we live in, and we have to kind of adapt ourselves to it. But more than that, we have to thrive in it. I don't want to just live in this world, even though it's an extroverted sensing world. I want to be able to thrive in it. I want to do really, 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 really well, even though I'm an INFJ, and even though the environment doesn't really agree with me, you know? I hope this makes sense. Again, if you guys have any questions at all, please message me anytime. If you have any suggestions for future videos, also message me. All my contact information is in the description below, or you can just comment below. I read all comments and I reply back to all of them as well. So please do message me. I love hearing from you guys. Again, I shall see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.